Why money was a word, my dear students. We are going to, good morning, I am Manu Prabhe from Ambuja Public School, Rabri Awas. Today we are going to study money chapter 4, right? So my first thing is that related with the why money was evolved, right? Why money was evolved? Because the reason is that because barter system, had many drawbacks. Barter system had many drawbacks, right? So because of the drawbacks of barter system, we have to evolve some other measure. We have to evolve some other measure that is called money, right? Money has removed all the drawbacks of barter system, and now the transaction, doing the transaction is very easy. Give money, take the thing. Pay the price, take the thing. So it is very easy. So now, why barter system was failed, right? Before studying about this, what is barter system, we will study here one thing. What is barter system? Exchange of goods with goods. This is the barter system. Exchange of goods with goods. So my dear student, exchange of goods with goods was very difficult thing. It requires double coincidence of want. Double coincidence of want, you know, which was very difficult to meet, right? So this was the one of the very biggest disadvantage or drawback of barter system. There were many other limitations, right? But this was the one of the very, very biggest drawback of, you know, barter system. So barter system has had many limitations. Due to these limitations, money was expounded. Money was expounded, you know, these limitations were first, right, lack of double coincidence of wants, then measurement of value commodity, third, division of commodity, fourth, standard of future payments, lag. Then fifth, storage of goods. These were the five major limitations of barter system. In the first point, lack of double coincidental bond means both people should have demand for each other commodities. But you know, sometimes there is a problem. What is the problem? That suppose there are two person, A and B. Now A has rice, B has wheat. A want wheat, but B want sugar. Then how things will exchange? This is called lack of double coincidence of want, means both person do not require each other commodities. When the both person do not require each other commodities, it means there is a lack of double coincidence of want. They have to exchange their goods with some other person. They have to find that person. It may take lot of time, it may take 1 month, it may take 2 months, it may take even week, maybe a day, right? But there is a problem of lack of double coincidence of want. Then second, measurement of value of commodity. It was also difficult to measure the value of the commodity, because my dear student, measurement of value of commodity was very difficult. Which commodity is more precious, which commodity is not so precious? There was no tool for comparison of the commodity, right? See, then this was the another problem. So then third is division of commodity. Division, a commodity cannot be divided. A commodity cannot be divided and sold, right? And especially it happens in the case of livestock. It happens in the case of livestock, like goat, like buffalo, cows, like other things. We cannot divide and sold them. So that was another problem in the barter system, right? See, because my dear student, livestock cannot be divided and sold. We have to sell it completely, otherwise it would be of no use, right? See, then there is a problem of standard of future payment. Now how much to make the payment if a person has taken anything on credit from other person, right? What amount he has to pay off a commodity in the future, which is decided by the other person who has given the commodity on credit to the other person. So that was the another problem of the barter system. So, but then the last problem was related with the storage of good. Storage of good means, my dear student, goods cannot be stored for very long time in comparison to money. Right, money can be stored for long time and it can multiply. So goods cannot be stored for very long time. That was the another problem in the barter system. So to remove all these problems, money was evolved. Money was evolved. This was the reason, main reason money was evolved by the people, right? So this money do not have their own value, but my dear student, still it works on the basis of, on the order of the central government of every country, right? So my dear student, that is why money was evolved, to remove the limitations of barter system. What is money? Now, money, simple, very simple definition. Money means anything which has general acceptability, which has general acceptability and act as medium of exchange and measures of value. Right. This is called money. Right. Money has two kind of main functions. Right. Which we can show here. Now, my dear student, we were discussed you functions of money. They are basically we can divide into three parts, but I am taking only two parts. Functions of money, primary function and secondary function. There are one more function, contingent function, which I am not going to discuss here. Right. So primary functions are two: medium of exchange. Money can be used to exchange goods. Exchange goods and commodities. How? Pay the money and take the goods. That is called medium of exchange. Then it made the medium of exchange very easy. Now you don't require to carry the goods into the market. You can directly purchase goods with the help of money. Money can measure the value of all commodities, secondary function, right? We can explain the value of commodities in terms of money. So this is also very beneficial for people of the whole world. So money can measure the value of each and everything, even medicine, even goods, right? Even eatable goods, even durable goods, perishable goods, whatever amount of goods are available in the market. Their value we can define in the money. So these are the two primary functions of the money. Then we have secondary functions here. These secondary functions are four. I am taking four, right? The first is standard of deferred payment. Deferred payment means future payment. With the help of money, we can calculate how much a borrower has to pay in future to the lender. Right. This amount we can calculate and he can pay in the form of EMI or in the form of, you know, whole amount plus principal amount. A whole amount is equal to principal amount plus rate of interest. So this can also be measured very easily with the help of money. This can also tell the how much is the increase in the payment, right, of the borrower in future. How much a borrower has to pay in the future, we can divide it into each into small EMIs for 1 month, for one monthly, quarterly, or half yearly, or annually. Right, this is the thing. Then, my dear student, then store of value. Money can be stored very easily, right? It can store also, and by storing in the bank, we can multiply the value of money. This is another great function of the money. So, money, don't keep money at home, keep the money at bank, and bank will give your rate of interest also, as well as your money will be multiplied. So portability, it is very easy to carry the money. It is very easy to carry the money from one place to another place, and it was not easy to carry the goods from one place to another place. This was also a very bombastic function of, you know, money. So another function, important function of money, was transferability. Money can be transferred through internet, right, through other digital payments measures to the any person in this world, right, very easily. So my dear student, so these are the main functions of money, right? So transferability, so main functions of money are divided into two part: medium of exchange, measure of value; secondary functions, standard of deferred payment, store of value, portability, transferability. ठीक है, these are the main functions. Okay, thank you my dear student, you're welcome. Next time once again I will meet you with the top chapter of bank. Okay, good day.